There is an elegant, useful, and widely popular equation in fluid mechanics called as Bernoulli's equation. So in this video, we are going to understand what that equation is and derive it. For this purpose, I have taken a pipe, as you can see. There are two things to note in this pipe. First one is that the cross section of the pipe is different at both the levels. At lower level, let's assume the cross section is A1. And at the higher level, let's assume the cross section is A2. And the location of these cross sections is also different. So one is located at a height H1 from the ground, and the other one is located at a height H2 from the ground. Now we'll assume that there's a liquid whose density is rho that is flowing inside this pipe at some velocity. The velocity here is V1, and the velocity here is V2. Now to choose my system, I am going to imagine that the liquid contained between the part A, B is my system. At some instant t, there was some liquid, and then in a small time interval delta t, this liquid moved. The position A changed to A dash and the position B changed to B dash. So the same amount of liquid that was contained between A, B has moved to A dash, B dash. Now, as discussed before, the amount of liquid delta m contained in this segment AA dash is going to be equal to the amount of liquid that is contained between BB dash. Then this will also be delta m. If you want to find out what is delta m, then delta m is volume that is equal to, in this section the volume will be V1 delta t into A1, because this distance is V1 delta t. So delta m for this cross section A1 is rho V1 delta t into A1, and the mass that is in this section BB dash is rho V2 delta t into A2. This here is V2 delta t, and these both masses are equal. So from here we'll see that we get the equation of continuity once again. So rho rho and delta t get cancelled out, and A1 V1 will be equal to A2 V2. So let's assume that this is our equation number 1. Now what I want to do is, I want to figure out all the forces acting on this and find out the work done by those forces. Why do I want to do that? It's because I want to apply work energy theorem in this case. So work energy theorem simply states, that the work done by all the forces on a system is equal to change in kinetic energy of the system. So work done by all the forces on a system will be equal to change in its kinetic energy, which will be equal to its final kinetic energy minus initial kinetic energy. So I want to do that for this assumed system, where I've assumed that there is some liquid. To do so, let me figure out all the forces. So I know that the liquid on the left hand side of this section AA dash is applying force on this face, and this force is pressure at this point into the area. So the force which is getting applied from this side is F1, where F1 is, I'll just write it here, F1 is pressure at that point, let's say P1 into A1. And the liquid on the right hand side of B, this part, is also applying some force on the face B. And this force is directed leftwards. Let's call this F2. And we'll have F2 as P2 into A2. These two forces are doing work. To understand it mathematically, work is defined as F dot ds. So if the force and the displacement are in the same direction, then the work done is positive. And if the force and displacement are in the opposite direction, then the work done will be negative. In this case, the work done by F1 is actually positive, because the displacement is in the rightward direction, that is AA dash, and so is the force. But the work done by F2 is actually negative, because as you can see, the layer moves from B to B dash in the rightward direction, but the force is acting leftwards. So let's just write down the work done by these forces. So work done by F1 is P1A1, that is a force, into displacement, that is V1 into delta T. Work done by F2 is P2A2 into V2 delta T with a negative sign, right? So these are the works done by the forces on the left hand side of the fluid and on the right hand side of the fluid on the system. Is there any other force? Obviously there is gravity, and gravity is acting downwards. So how to figure out the work done by gravity? You know that the gravitational force is a conservative force, so the work done doesn't depend upon the path taken. If we try to figure out the work done by gravity on our system in this case, let's look at this. The section, the liquid contained between AB has moved to A dash B dash. And as you can see in this change of configuration, the liquid which was enclosed between A dash and B, this liquid is the same. So previously it was a part of this fluid, and later on it is a part of this fluid, which is common. So in order to find out the work done by gravity on the system, we can ignore this part, because this part is going to get cancelled out. So we'll just focus on this part, that is the liquid contained between AA dash and the liquid contained between BB dash. If I want to find out the work done by gravity, then the work done by gravity will be equal to gravitational force, which is constant, that is mg, into displacement. Now the displacement, that is a vertical displacement, is upwards, because this guy has moved, this section of the liquid has moved from a height h1 to height h2. So the displacement is h2 minus h1, but the force is downwards. So work done by gravity is negative. So work done by gravity is minus delta mg into h2 minus h1. Is there any other force on the system? There are forces from the walls of the pipe, but these forces are perpendicular to the displacement. As we have assumed that there is no friction, the viscosity is zero, there are forces exerted by the walls like that on the liquid. But the force is like this and a displacement is like that, so the angle between them is 90. And F dot ds is F ds cos 90, which is zero. So normal reaction from the walls do not do any work on our system. Any other force that you can think of? I think that no other forces are left. All the forces are covered. So there are forces F1, F2. There's a force of gravity, and that's it. So the work done by all these three forces will be equal to change in kinetic energy of the system, which is work done by force F1 plus work done by force F2 plus work done by gravity will be equal to half final kinetic energy, that is delta M into V2 squared. So half delta M V2 squared minus half into delta M into V1 squared, as simple as that. So this is now what we are going to do. So work done by F1, that is P1 A1 into P1 A1 into V1 delta T into V1 delta T minus P2 A2 into V2 delta T minus delta M G H2 minus H1 equals to half delta M, I'm going to take this as common, V2 squared minus V1 squared. One thing that we can do from here now is that I know from this equation, if you focus here, delta M is equal to rho V1 delta T A1. So from this equation, I can find out the value of V1 A1 delta T. So V1 A1 delta T is equal to delta M by rho. From this equation, delta M is equal to rho V2 delta T A2. V2 A2 delta T, V2 A2 delta T is equal to delta M by rho. I can utilize this and make my equation more simpler, where I can substitute the value of V1 A1 delta T and V2 A2 delta T as delta M by rho. So I am going to do that here. A1 V1 delta T, I'll put it as P1 into delta M by rho minus P2 into delta m by rho minus delta m g h2 minus h1 is equal to half delta m v2 squared minus v1 squared. And I can see delta m getting cancelled out from all the sides. And if I take the rho as LCM on the left hand side and take rho on the right hand side, I'll get P1 minus P2 minus rho g h2 minus h1 equals to half rho v2 squared minus half rho v1 squared. Now if I take all the 1s on one side and all the 2s on the other side, I'll get P1 plus rho g h1 plus half rho v1 squared, because this guy is going to come to the left hand side, become positive, will be equal to P2 plus rho g h2 plus half rho v2 squared. And that's it. So one thing that we can note here is that 1 and 2 were any two random points inside this pipe. So we didn't say that, okay, 1 is particularly this and 2 is particularly that. We just assumed that there were two sections, 1 and 2, and velocities were some v1, v2, and the pressures were some p1, p2, and then we found out this relation. So this is a general relation which is very elegant, which just states that this sum p plus rho gh plus half rho v squared in any section of a fluid that is flowing in a pipe is a constant. And this is our Bernoulli's equation. So I hope you understand the mathematics behind it. It's not that complicated. So I'll just revise it for you. So we started from a pipe and it had varying cross section and different heights of the cross section that we assumed. And we assumed that the liquid contained between part A and B is our system. And in some time interval delta T, this liquid moved to a new configuration A dash B dash. And what we did, the main thing was we applied work energy theorem, which says that work done by all the forces is equal to change in kinetic energy of the system. And when we figured out all the forces, F1, F2 and gravity, and we found out the work done, and we just equated it to change in kinetic energy of the system. And we used this equation later on in our substitution, that this guy rho V1 delta T A1 is equal to delta M, which is also equal to rho V2 delta T into A2. And after all substitution, we found out an elegant form which says that the summation of pressure rho gh and half rho v squared in a pipe where the fluid is flowing steadily is a constant.